Welcome back, everyone. If you are nearing retirement, of course, there's always a bundle that you need to know.
Yeah, there is a huge but little known retirement risk. We are joined by Alex Menassa from Szarka Financial with more. And you're, we're talking about easy listening. You're making me nervous. Because we want to retire,
I don't mean to do that.
Take it easy, relax once I get to age 65. But you're saying after you reach 62, 65, 70, whenever you want to retire, you need to be careful.
Well, of course. And one of the most surprising but little known risks people face to their investments is something called sequence of return risk. Everybody, people don't know about it, but people should be aware of what it is.
What is it?
Well, here's the thing. See, when you're building and accumulating money, it doesn't matter when you have good years or bad years in the market. What matters is the average return you get.
Okay.
So let's say from 30 to age 60, you're saving, you're building. It doesn't matter what order the good and bad years are. But once you retire, it's a different story. If you are retired and taking money out of your portfolio, if you get hit early on with some negative years, it can permanently cripple your retirement income.
Is it just because you're taking money out?
Yes, if you're taking money out, because what happens is you can have two people just the same amount of money and the same income they're taking out. But one retires in 2007, the other retires in 2010. And they can both be retired for 30 years. The first one could end up running out of money, where the other one grows their money forever. And the reason is because the first one got hit with negative years early on. You have to sell shares when they're down, and you never have those shares back. That's
okay,
the problem.
Something happens, you're 67 years old, and you have a family crisis, and you need to tap into your retirement. And walk us through, how do you combat something like that? How do you not take out the money when you really need it?
That's exactly what everybody has to think about if they're near retirement. There are things you can do with your portfolio. You have to think ahead. What if I get hit with some bad years early on? What am I going to do? And you have to put a plan together for that. So there's different things you can do, different ways to combat that. But everyone has to have some kind of plan for it.
Like what? What are some of the things that you can do to lessen your risk?
Here's one. Nobody wants to hear this. One is if you can cut back on the income you're taking in a bad year. If you can do that, then you can give yourself a lot more cushion, okay? But what if you can't? A lot of people need that income.
I mean, you need it for your house payments. You need it for your house payments or
and
to keep your car going.
Healthcare expenses.
Yeah.
Another one is to carefully blend the kind of assets you have in your portfolio so that the volatility is and correlation is different between them. So you never have too much of your portfolio going down at any one time. That's another way to do it. A third way is to what we call the bucket theory, to have some liquid assets, in short-term bonds, to tide you over for, let's say, 2 or 3 years worth of expenses, so you never have to sell your stock when it's down. And then a fourth way, there are lots of different ways. Another one is to have certain mutual funds where the fund itself takes action in case there's a big down market to not go down too much. Mm.
So a lot of folks out there have financial planners. What should they be talking to their financial planners about? How should they be framing their questions right now?
They should be evaluating the portfolio and asking, what happens with the income I'm taking out if there's a bear market? And we are overdue for a market correction. It doesn't mean it's going to happen anytime soon. We've been overdue for quite a while, but we haven't had a 5%.
How would that affect it, Alex?
Well, because we're overdue for a correction now. So if you're retiring or retired now and you're taking money out and we have a market correction, you could be put in that trap where you have to sell your shares when they're down and you'll be a victim of sequence of
returns.
Where's
REM? I need that REM music.
I know.
Back.
So calm me down.
$2 into my investment, $1 in the mattress is what you're saying. $2 here, $1 in the
mattress. At least you have a plan. That way. That's the key. Have a plan.
Oh, boy. If you have financial questions or need more information, go to the experts like we do. Szarka Financial Services and Mr. Alex Menassa here. And you can, of course, head to our website, foxaid.com, and click on Scene on TV for a link to all their information. But good folks, good stuff.
And I think, what you said is key. You've got to have a plan. And many people end up at the retirement terrified.
That's right. Yeah. Think ahead and
not planning
plan.
Enough.
Because running a lemonade stand at 83 is not a good idea. No. You're not going to make a lot of money at that.
Thank you,
Alex.
Appreciate it.